Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. Here I'm just going to show you one more new product. It's a DZ09 smart Bluetooth watch. So basically this is the things which we get inside the box. It's a user manual, then we have a micro USB cable for charging this watch. Like at least you have to charge like 2 to 3 hours for getting the full charge. And this is a smart watch with the nice strap. It's a black one. So basically you can see on the top, this is a camera. Okay, it's a VGA camera. Then exactly like on the left side, you can see there's a small hole. We can say it's a mic. Then on the below side, this is on off button. Okay, like you can say like boot button. If you want to just turn it on, you can just long press it, then it will turn on, and the same process for the turning it off. Then on the left side, you can see over here, it's a micro USB port. So you can just directly charge with the help of the micro USB cable. If we come back side, on the right corner, this is a speaker. Okay, so now I'll show you, like I'm just opening this back case cover. Okay, so basically you see over here, like it's a 3.7 volt battery, and capacity you can see 380 mAh battery, and this is a serial number you can see. Now I'm just going to remove the battery. Like it's a removable battery, so you can easily remove it. Now here it's a SIM slot, and exactly beside of the SIM slot, this is a micro SD card slot, which is support up to 32 GB. Now I'm just going to insert this SIM card first, and it will support micro SIM, not nano SIM. Now we have just inserted the SIM card and SD card as well. So now I'm just going to put the battery again. Now just press this on off button for like 2 to 3 seconds. Now you can see it started like smartwatch. You will get this kind of icon. Now the SIM will be initialized, and it's searching the network. On right side top corner you can see it's a searching. On the left side corner you can see we just got the network. Now we'll just see about some function of this smartwatch, and we'll first of all we'll see some menu. Like so first, before on the home page you can see like we have call function, and then we have a call books. So you can directly like access it over here. Like just press this icon and you can just dial the call. I'm just dialing the one number. Otherwise you can direct, if you want to directly access it, you can on the left side, you can just press over here and you will get the all contact. Then press the middle one button, it's the green one, calling function. Then it will ask you like local call or BT call. Just press OK. And it's dialing, we are getting the all option. Like if you want to just speaker, you can just do it speaker. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah. Once. Now if you come on the second page, this is the alarm function. Then we have messaging, then profile, then call logs for the receive call, miss call or dial calls, you can see it. Then we have like dialer, then phone book, then settings, calendar. On the other page like Bluetooth, then we have audio player, then calendar, then image viewer, then camera, then we have like sanitary reminder, like you can just set the time and it will remind you every time. Then we have a remote notifier, then file manager, then remote capture, you can just take the picture from over here through your phone. Then antilost, like if you want to just find out your phone, you can just use. Then sleep monitor, then we have pedometer, then this is QR code. Then we have some social application like Twitter, Facebook and WhatsApp. And this is a browser. First of all, we'll check the settings. So just press on setting. Then we have like watch setting. First option, like you can just set the time and date, like set home city. Then we have a set time and date, set time format like 12 hours or 24 hours. Then the main option is the language. Like sometime if you want to just change the language, you can just go to the settings and like select the second function. It's a language, just press on it. And we got like many kind of language like English, then Spanish, then like Czech Republic, then Greek. Then we have like prefer input method, then display, then motion. Like you can just set the motion sensor, like for the flip to mute incoming call. Like you can just flip the watch and it will automatically like mute the call. Then flip mute alarm, the same function. Then wake up gesture. Then we have flight mode and miscellaneous settings like LCD backlight. You can just adjust the brightness. Then we come to the network setting. Then we have security settings, like SIM security and watch security. Here you can just set the pin lock. Then if you want to change the pin, you can do it. So this is a security purpose, like for your watch. Then connectivity. This is very useful function, like for the Bluetooth. So you can like connect this smartwatch with your phone through the Bluetooth. And the last one is like restore settings. Okay, and it will ask you the password. So in the restore setting, the password will be 1122. Once you reset the watch, all data will be gone. Then we have audio player. Now in audio player you can see there is a no track. So in that case, what you need to do, you have to just press this settings. Now it will ask you like BTU music or local list. So in the BTU music, like you can just play the music from your phone. Otherwise in the local list, like you can just play the all songs from your micro SD card. Okay, so just press this local list. Okay, now you can see it's empty. So press this option, then add. Now you can see I'm just accessing my SD card and the songs. Now you can see here it is, all songs available. Now you can add like as per your requirement, select and OK. Select and OK. Now come back to on audio player. Okay, you can see, now press any one of them. Now if you want to increase the volume, just press this plus button. If you want to go next, you can just press this right arrow, like forward. This is next. And if you want to just pause, you can just press this middle button. Now it's paused. The same way, if you want to backward, just press this. Like this. And if you want to decrease the volume, just press the minus. So this is the music player. Now this is camera. Just press on it, now you can see the camera is over here, like the lens is on the top. Then we have file manager option, like you can see it's a memory card. Then you can add like whatever you want to access it, you can do it. Like I'm just, if you want to access the images or photo, you can do it. Then on another page, like we have a remote capture, then anti-lost, then sleep monitor and pedometer. So now first of all, what you need to do, you have to turn on the Bluetooth of your phone. You have to just pair a new device. Okay, now you can see we just got like DZ09. But in some case, if you didn't find your watch name, then what you need to do, you have to just go to settings. Okay, then we have select the like connectivity. Okay, you have to just select the connectivity. Then we have Bluetooth option. In Bluetooth you can see like power, then visibility, search on new device and my name. Okay, it's a DZ09, and if you want to change the name, you can do it. Okay, so when you have to turn on this device, the Bluetooth will automatically on. But if you want to just turn it off, or if you want to just change the visibility, you can do it from the connectivity, like by accessing the settings. Now just connect this. Once you pair it with your phone, it will ask you like password match. You have to just press the yes and from your phone. But and if you want to like allow access to your contacts and call history, you can just press over here by checkbox and just pair it. And just press yes. Now DP connected, you can see like the Bluetooth is connected with my phone. Now if I'm calling through my phone, I will get the notification in my smartwatch as well. I will show you. I'm just dialing the call from my phone. Now you can see, I'll just dial the number from my phone and you can see over here as well. The same way, if you just dial in the number from over here, you will also get this same notification in your phone. Like if you are driving or something, then you can directly attend the call from your smartwatch. Now for accessing the some features, you have to just install the application. As I said earlier, this is the quick response you can see. Okay, you have to click over here and you will get the one QR code. Now just take your mobile and open the QR code scanner, then scan the QR. Now just click on the given link, open it and download it, and the application name is United Power Bluetooth Notification. Now I have just downloaded the application. Now it's asking me like, do you want to install the application? Okay, install it. Once it's installed, you have to just now open it. Then it will ask you like allow. So yes, you have to select all, you have to just allow all the notification and all that things. Like it will access your like contacts and all that things. Okay, now we just got, this is the main page, like home page for the application. Now you get you can see below of the like middle motion data and mine. Okay, so you have to just select the mine option, the last one. Now here you can see like find device, remote alarm clock, then we have different function available. So first of all, what you need to do, you have to just go to the Bluetooth setting. Okay, then you can see over here, like if you are pairing this first time, you have to select the first option, but we have already connected, so that time you have to just check the previously connected device. Now select the DZ09 and connecting. Okay, it's, you can see it's a DP connected. Now it's asking me like sync data and time with remote device. Okay, that means, so you have to just press on yes, so time and all data will be synced in your smartwatch. You will also get the notification like from the WhatsApp, Facebook, like whatever you whatever you given the access for the application. Now I will just show you the remote access function, how to access it. Like you can see over here, we have camera, all that things. Like this is the remote capture and we have antilost function available. So in the remote capture, what will happen, like whenever you click over here in remote capture, your phone camera will on like this. Just press on it. Okay, now you can see. If you want to capture it, just press over here. Now it's capturing, you can see. Now we have anti-lost function, like it will help you to find out your watch or a phone. Now you can see there is a looking phone and anti-lost. So whenever you like press on looking phone, it will ringing and you will also get notification in your mobile like this. And in mobile you can see like please cancel the bell, so just press the determine and it will cancel. Okay, and in anti-lost function you can just set like status and alert type, like ring or vibrate or ring or vibrate. Now we'll see the function of the application, and here is the first function you can see, it's a find device. So whenever you just select the find device, your smart will make a ringing like watch has been found. So in that case, like if you forgot like where have you been put this watch before, and if you can't find this, you can directly like open the application and you can just check the find my device, the watch will ring in. Now determine it again. Then we have a remote alarm clock. In the remote alarm clock, you can just set the time, okay, whatever you want to, and it will make a ring the same time. Now we have SMS post function. Then we have always send a notification. So if you want to turn it on, you can just like, if you want to turn it off, you can do it. Otherwise, just make it turning on. And this is the notification application, which is most usable. So basically, you can like allow like whatever you want to get notification in your smartwatch, you can just allow it like WhatsApp or a Facebook. You can see over here. And if you want to like, if you don't want to give any notification, you can disable it like this. Then the same way like accessibility settings,
you can see. Then we have Bluetooth settings and user help, and the last one is like firmware, like new version update. So basically this watch is very useful. Like you can just make like this, you can directly insert the SIM card, you can insert the micro SD card, and you can just make a call. And the same way you can also handle your, like you can just control your phone by this smartwatch. So if you like our video, then please share and subscribe. Thank you.